In this module of the Microsoft Teams tutorial, I'll go over the key components of the interface in Microsoft Teams. Once you're signed into Microsoft Teams, at the very top here we have the search bar. Here you can search for messages, files, and you can even put a slash and it'll display like anybody who is busy or anybody that is away or anyone that is available and so on with that status. To the right of the search box, we have the configuration icon, and notice you can check for updates, you can change the zoom, and you can go into the settings for this application, and I'll get into those at a later module. To the right of the configuration area, we have the account that we are signed in with, and this is where you can set your status if you're not setting it within your calendar, and this is where you can manage your account or switch accounts, or switch to Teams for personal use. Now on the left-hand side, this is where you have the various modules in Microsoft Teams. And the key modules in Microsoft Teams are the chat module, that is one of the default modules, where you can have private conversations one-on-one or instant conversations with members of the same team or teams across the organization. Then further down here, you have the Teams module. The Teams module, think of it as a sandbox, a virtual space for a group of individuals working together on a project. The Teams module will go into more details as to how to create teams and how to use the Teams module and the Channels module within the Teams component. For now, just get an understanding that you can create a team or you can join a team by entering a code to join that team. Further down, you have the calendar, and this is where you can schedule meetings and use the video conferencing tools. Further down, you have the calls option, and this is for organizations that have integrated the phone systems with Microsoft Teams. Further down, you have the files option, and this is where you can organize files to share with other individuals within Teams in conjunction with Microsoft OneDrive. Further down, this is where you can add or pin additional applications as part of your organization's approved applications, or you can click More Apps and pick from the list of applications, whether by category or by searching for any of the applications, navigating to any necessary applications that you want to integrate as part of Microsoft Teams. Further down here, you have the Help option. This is where you can learn about the various topics related to using Microsoft Teams. You can access Microsoft training on using Microsoft Teams, what's new, or suggest features, or post questions to the community, and so on. Now, in the very top left, you have the activity feed. This will be a listing of various activities, what's happening, whether it is a missed call, or chats coming in or going out, or mentions, or anything related to that. To learn Microsoft Teams, just keep in mind that the key components are going to be listed here on the left. Think of these as tabs. Then on the second column, you have the options where you can further configure items related to that module that you selected. So for example, right now I selected chat, and under chat I can switch from the chat module to the contacts module. And then on the top right, there are additional filtering tools or options to create a new chat and so on. Same thing with any of these other tabs. So we have here the calendar that we have selected, and then to the right of it, we have all the options related to the calendar. So stay tuned, and we are going to go into each one of those modules and cover those modules in depth. If you like this video, please press like, subscribe, and then click on the bell icon.